Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today I actually like to experiment something with Rhino to see if I can create those more of an ink texture inspired by the great artist Jackson Pollock. He has this beautiful ink gesture on it. So I did a little bit test and think this is very interesting things to share with you. So are you ready? Let's get started. What we want to achieve is this ink effect. As you can see, the edge is a little bit irregular. So as long as we can control what is underneath it, we can actually make it bigger or smaller, depends on what you put it underneath it. Okay, so that's what I would like to achieve, to have that look. But to making this dog tag, I also want to have a channel set all the way around. So let's go ahead to find out what is the regular size for the dog tag. Let's go to the Google and you can search for dog tag dimension. It gives us a dimension for 2 inch by 1/8 of the inch. So let's go to Rhino. So let me turn off that and that's starting from the scratch. So we want to use the rectangle center tool. Then we want snapping into the center. The width is 1.125 inch. Okay, and the high is 2 inch. Make sure you type it inch mark there because we are in the millimeter. So right now we have this. I'm going to use the arc tool. Simply just pick up the edge and snapping into the midpoint. And then let me mirror that to the other side. All we need to do now is to trim all the extra and then join them together. Now we need to make sure it's nice and smooth to wear. So let's go ahead around all the corners. In this case, fitted, I'm setting it 5. Okay, so right now we have this, and before we do the rest of the texture, I would like to work on the channel set on outside first. So that's snapping into midpoint, coming to here. I'm going to plan to set the 2 millimeter stone. So I would like to have the wall is about 1 millimeter on each side. So I'm gonna set up the width for 4. And then set up the height is about roughly a square. Depends on how high do you want them to look, right? So and then I'm going to copy another one up and kind of scale it down a little bit, right? So now I have roughly about 1 millimeter there. It can be a little bit narrower, that's fine. And then I'm gonna use the trim tool to trim off those lines there and join all those together. Once we join, we also want to bring in a stone and just see how it fit. You can find how to make a stone video here. I will put a link below so you know how to make a stone. But let me bring in the stone that I already did. So I bring in the stone roughly about 2 millimeter, and this is how it fitting into the profile. You don't have to have that much of a space, so we can actually make the interior a bit higher as long as you are not touching the tip, which is the cutlet of the stone. To help your jeweler to easy to set the stone, you can also do one more thing. Is actually you wanted to kind of giving a cut there. What it does is helping your jeweler to quickly to align all the tools, all the stone by those cutting line there. All right, so you can get it as close, and sometimes I intentionally make it like even cutting into the stone a little bit, because the jeweler, they will need to cut out the seed themselves anyway. But this is just a quick guideline there. So I'm going to hide the stone first and take a look on those lines. With this line, I'm going to mirror to the other side, and then with that I'm going to trim the line in the middle, and all we need to do now is join those together, and then we are ready to go. Now let's take a look on the top view. We have our profile now, so let's go ahead to use the sweep one rail. Then you have, this is a rail, this is the cross section. Then you will have the surface or poly surface like this. Okay, so let's go to the array, transform under the array. Then you have the along the curve. Let's select the stone first, and then select the path here. So that will be the original curve. We want to try something maybe 70 to start with, and let's see how it, as long as the stone is not touching, you will be fine. You might need to rearrange a little bit to put one more stone there, since there's a bigger gap there. But this is a tutorial for the texture, so I'm not going to spend time to do that. Okay, so once we have done that, I'm going to pick up the original curve again, and I want to give in a base there. So let's go into the side view, and going to the solid, you have extruded planar curve straight. So let's work on it and give it a little bit back there. So we are ready to creating our pattern. So now with this, I'm going to go into another layer, and I'm going to copy that curve that we have there to that layer, so we can temporary copy, so we can temporary to turn off those stone setting things. All right, now the pattern I'm going to work with, it can be spontaneous for anything. You can create any kind of a curve, as long as you can pipe it, that will be fine. So I'm going to do something like this, and you can work even, you know, cross straight line, or, you know, curve line, or whatever you like, or you can create a small section and it's kind of repeating pattern by copy and paste. So I'm just gonna, to save the time, I'm just going to create something really quick here, and you can spend some time to tweak it. All right, so with this, then I'm going to pipe it. You can pipe them whatever thickness you want to give it more variation. It's gonna make it look nicer. The one that I have really quick at the beginning of the video, that is basically for doing exactly the same, so I can do it big and small here. The one I showed you earlier in the video, that one is the same radius. So I'm going to just quickly doing something here so we can go to the next step. All right, so one more. Okay, so now this is what I have there. And then the command I'm going to use, okay, one more here. The command I'm going to use is called drap, all right? It's living under the surface tool, and you have this one look like a ghost here. It's called drap, all right? So that means I'm going to use the drap command, and it will ask you to draw a window. So I'm gonna draw a window that can cover entire area. Okay, and it looked like it's nothing changed, but if you take a look right there, you're going to see, you know, those are the surface that cover on top of it. Imagine that if you have a bunch of egg, this will be a egg packaging. That will be the similar idea like that. Okay, so now we have this surface right there. All we need to do is to trim off the flat area that we don't want. The best way I find is actually draw a straight line across something like this, and then we can trim anything underneath it. So those extra, we don't need it, we can trim it. Okay, That's the curve. Okay, so now I have something like this. Let's take a look on what we have. All right, so it depends on the arrangement that you have. You might have a different type of a draping, waving on the side. And then we just need to pick up the one and that we need. And we can go to the selection tool that's reverse the selection, and we can delete the rest of it that we don't need. Okay, so this is the pattern. Now, if the pattern for you is kind of too rough, another command you can use is called smooth, right? For this command, it's gonna come up this window, and you can, it will ask you like how smooth you want it. It's kind of giving you this bar you can slice, like seeing how smooth you want it. And then so you can play around to giving more zigzag, or you know, more smoother surface or things like that. And that will give you more like effect on the ink looking things. And again, you might need to try more time to get what you like. All right, so once you have that, you can go ahead to trim all the extra that you don't need with the one that we have there. All right, so once you are done, let's go back to the top view. Okay, so that is the ink texture that we have. And then I can turn on my rest of it and then adjust the high on it, and you can get it a little bit inside of it, right? So now you have this ink looking surface inside of the Dogtag. This is my little experiments, just want to share with you. I hope you enjoy it, like it, please leave a comment, let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next Monday.